And there came a time known as the third millennium, a time when the people of the earth were ravaged by disease, pestilence, and poisons. A time when the horsemen of the apocalypse ran the multinational corporations. A time when America's citizens were waking up to a future of no money and no jobs. A time when a special man came forward, a man that your American taskmasters did not want you to see or hear. A man whom they took prisoner and hid away. A man whose name is Yahweh BenYahweh. For telling people the truth, Yahweh BenYahweh was taken prisoner by the minions of darkness. For giving people hope, Yahweh BenYahweh was led away to Golgotha. This is the continuing story of the past and of the future, about good and about evil, about your life and what it will become. A story that tells why the so-called black man of America had to suffer for over 400 years. A story of what will happen to the so-called black man if he returns to the laws, statutes, judgments, and commandments of God, YahwehBenYahweh.
Olam shall YahwehBenYahweh. The universe of YahwehBenYahweh. Brought to you by the nation of YahwehBenYahweh. Working for you and your future.
Good or evil, life or death. This is your choice in this, the year 6002, the year of judgment. Shalom and welcome to the universe of Yahweh. My name is Josiah Israel and I am your host. For over 7 years now, we have been discussing some of the things the Bible said would occur in the day of judgment. We warned you that the weather was going to change and that the powerful forces of nature were going to bring terrible destruction upon America and the world, and that it was going to get worse and worse and worse, and it has. We alerted you that violence in the public schools was going to increase, and it has. We showed you in the scriptures that forewarned of wickedness in high places, and we are witnessing today gross misconduct and serious crimes being committed by some of our highest elected officials. What lies ahead for America and the world is nothing less than the proliferation of deadly diseases and plagues as foretold in the Bible. But there is hope. The Bible tells us that at the end, the Messiah would be revealed. And at that time, he would save the righteous from this impending destruction. That one, the Messiah, is Yahweh BenYahweh. So we invite you to join us in the universe of Yahweh, featuring the commandments of Yahweh and the Messiah revealed. First, the commandments of Yahweh.
For 6,000 years, we have been suffering at the hands of rulers who transgress the laws of YahwehBenYahweh and teach all people throughout the earth to transgress the laws of YahwehBenYahweh. In order to have peace, love, and harmony upon the earth, we must return to keeping the commandments, judgments, laws, and statutes of YahwehBenYahweh. All of us have been taught that the commandments, judgments, laws, and statutes in the Old Testament Bible do not count today. In this series, we will show you that the commandments, judgments, laws, and statutes in the Old Testament Bible do count, and that if we govern our lives according to these commandments, judgments, laws, and statutes of God YHWH, then we will have peace and goodwill upon the earth forever. We invite you to study along with us. However, in order to do so, you must have the following tools: a King James Version of the Bible, several dictionaries, the New Strong's Exhaustive Concordance, a set of encyclopedias, Hebrew and Greek lexicons, a thesaurus, and a synonym finder.
Shalom. My name is Ben Kayo Bethel Yisrael. We are discussing the commandments of Yahweh. And more specifically, we are discussing the fact that the first direct commandment that Yahweh ever gave to man was given to Adam in the Garden of Eden, which was to dress it. Our discussion last week centered around the fact that the Sabbath of Yahweh is a day to rest and to be refreshed. We showed you in the dictionary that the word rest means a period of relaxation or freedom from work, activity, worry, and so on, or relief or freedom, especially from troubles. We showed you that the word refresh means to enliven the mind or spirit, to revive. And we documented that revive means to restore to life or consciousness, or to renew in the mind. We read in Exodus chapter 31, verse 17, that on the seventh day, Yahweh himself rested and was refreshed. In like manner, he commanded Adam to do likewise, to rest and be refreshed, and to teach his descendants to do the same. We explained that to observe or celebrate the seventh day as a day of rest, Adam was commanded to relax and free his mind from all work, activity, worry, and troubles, and to enliven his mind and spirits with the knowledge of Yahweh, which would restore his life or consciousness to a renewed state. We read Colossians chapter 3, verse 10, and learned that by doing this, Adam would put on the new man, meaning a new mind, after the image of Yahweh himself. We concluded that on the Sabbath, Adam, his descendants, and all the families of the earth are to rest and refresh our minds in the knowledge of Yahweh, and to give exclusive honor to the memory of Yahweh for all his work, his creation, which he, Yahweh, created and made. Today, we will continue to discuss the specifics of the direct commandment that Yahweh gave to Adam in the Garden of Eden, which was to dress it. Dress in Hebrew is abad, and one of its meanings is worshiper. Worshiper, as it relates to dress, means that Yahweh commanded Adam to cause the whole world to obey, comply with, or conform to, as law, the observance or celebration of the seventh day as the Sabbath of Yahweh, to honor the memory of Yahweh for all his work, which he, Yahweh, created and made. Let us look at the meaning of Sabbath in Hebrew from still another perspective. The New Strong's Exhaustive Concordance of the Bible, copyright 1990, in the Hebrew and Chaldee Dictionary section on page 112, reference number 7673, Sabbath also means keep. Referenced in the Synonym Finder by J.I. Rodale, copyright 1978, on page 623, keep is synonymous to observe. Documented in Webster's Ninth New Collegiate Dictionary, copyright 1989, on page 815, observe means to conform one's action or practice to as a law. Conform means to bring into harmony or agreement to be obedient. So when Yahweh commanded Adam to dress the Garden of Eden, he was commanding Adam to bring all his actions into harmony or agreement with the law by practicing and keeping the Sabbath of Yahweh. He was also commanding Adam to teach his descendants to observe the Sabbath of Yahweh and to be obedient to this law forever, according to Exodus chapter 31, verse 16, which reads, "Wherefore the children of Israel shall keep the Sabbath, to observe the Sabbath throughout their generations for a perpetual covenant." Adam's descendants, the children of Israel, are to keep and observe the Sabbath of Yahweh throughout their generations for a perpetual covenant. On the authority of the Synonym Finder by J.I. Rodale on page 875, the word perpetual is equivalent to everlasting, eternal, infinite, and never-ending. The Webster's Ninth New Collegiate Dictionary, page 300, defines covenant as a written agreement or promise, usually under seal between two or more parties. Yahweh commanded Adam to teach all of his descendants, the children of Israel, that keeping the Sabbath of Yahweh is an everlasting, eternal, infinite, and never-ending agreement or promise. Not only was Adam commanded to make this known to his descendants, but he was also commanded to make this known to all people who joined themselves to Yahweh, as written in Isaiah chapter 56, verses 6 and 7, which reads in part, "Also the sons of the stranger that joined themselves to Yahweh, to serve him and to love the name of Yahweh, to be his servants, everyone that keepeth the Sabbath from polluting it and taketh hold of my covenant, even them will I bring to my holy mountain and make them joyful in my house of prayer. For mine house shall be called an house of prayer for all people." To dress the Garden of Eden means that Yahweh commanded Adam to make known to his descendants, Israel, and all people of the earth who joined themselves to Yahweh, to serve him, to love his name, and to take hold of his written agreement or promise, that keeping the Sabbath of Yahweh is an everlasting, eternal, infinite, and never-ending agreement throughout their generations. And Yahweh commanded Adam to make known to his descendants, Israel, and all people of the earth who joined themselves to Yahweh, that if they keep the Sabbath of Yahweh, then Yahweh himself would bring all of us to the holy mountain and make us joyful in his house of prayer. Next week, we shall continue our discussion of the Sabbath and what it means. I bear witness to you today that the Messiah, Yahweh ben Yahweh, is here.
I bear witness to you today that the Mahdi is here.
I bear witness to you today that Shiloh is here.
I bear witness to you today that the great light is here.
I bear witness to you today that the Grand Master of the Celestial Lodge, Architect of the Universe, is here.
I bear witness to you today that the Enlightened One is here.
I bear witness to you today that the One all religions have been speaking of for almost 6,000 years is here.
Thank you for listening, and join us next week as we continue our discussion of the commandments of Yahweh.
What does eternal life mean? Eternal life means life without end. It means forever. Not only during the time of one's natural life, but through endless ages of eternal life and blessedness. To find out more, read The Messiah Revealed by Yahweh Ben Yahweh. To order, call us at 1-800-967-7337 or check out our new website and online bookstore at www.yahwehbenyahweh.com. What is the Tetragrammaton? What are the laws and teachings of Yahweh Ben Yahweh? What is the meaning of the crucifixion? What are the laws of the covenant? How can you work to balance justice? How can you hear the voice of Yahweh? Learn the answers to these questions and many more on the internet when you visit the new Yahweh Ben Yahweh website. The address is www.yahwehbenyahweh.com.
To Exodus, release our God to us. It was prophesied that when the Son of Man appears, there would be a time of great and terrible natural disasters. This is Judgment Day, and YHWH is plaguing and judging this world. His judgment is great in America because this country has judicially murdered his son, YHWH, Beit Nun Sofit YHWH, hanged him on the cross and is holding him in prison for crimes he did not commit and refuses to let him go. This is why YHWH, the God of the Bible, is blitzing America and the world with his treasures of snow. Headline: Midwest tries to cope with flooding. Flooding made worse by melting chunks of snow and ice forced evacuations in Minnesota. Headline: Floodwaters, ice, and snow plague U.S. Several states appealed for federal help after a powerful spring snowstorm blocked roads, knocked out power lines, and swelled already overflowing rivers, leaving thousands homeless. Let us turn to and read Job chapter 38, verses 22 and 23. Has thou entered into the treasures of the snow? Or has thou seen the treasures of the hail, which I, YHWH, have reserved against the time of trouble, against the day of battle and war? How much more of this freezing, cold weather can we take? Is there a way to stop it all? Yes, there is. And YHWH, Beit Nun Sofit YHWH, holds the key. However, until the release of YHWH, Beit Nun Sofit YHWH, the present course of natural disasters worldwide shall continue to get worse and worse and worse. Shalom, and we'll see you next week on Exodus. Release our God to us.
Who is worthy to open the book? Who is worthy to open the book and loose the seals thereof.
And in the midst of the seven candlestick, one like unto the Son of Man, clothed with a garment down to the foot, and girt about the paps with a golden girdle. His head and his hairs were white like wool, as white as snow, and his eyes were as a flame of fire, and his feet like unto fine brass, as if they burned in a furnace, and his voice as the sound of many waters. At the end of time of evil rule, the Anointed One, the Messiah, shall appear. In 1979, YahwehBenYahweh came to Miami and became the spiritual leader and founder of the Nation of Yahweh. Although he took a vow of poverty, in 7 years he guided the nation to amass a $250 million empire. Under his direction, the Nation of Yahweh has grown to encompass disciples, followers, and supporters in over 1,300 cities within the U.S. and 16 foreign countries. YahwehBenYahweh is bringing about changes in the lives of individuals and is giving the world the keys to success in life, politically, economically, educationally, socially, and spiritually.
Yahweh is bringing YahwehBenYahweh forth into a large place. Yahweh is delivering YahwehBenYahweh because he delights in him. Moreover, Yahweh is rewarding YahwehBenYahweh according to his righteousness. According to the cleanness of his hands is Yahweh recompensing YahwehBenYahweh. For YahwehBenYahweh is keeping the ways of Yahweh, and he has not wickedly departed from his God. For all the judgments of Yahweh were before YahwehBenYahweh, and Yahweh did not put away his statutes from YahwehBenYahweh. YahwehBenYahweh is upright before Yahweh, and YahwehBenYahweh is keeping himself from iniquity. Therefore, Yahweh is recompensing YahwehBenYahweh according to his righteousness, according to the cleanness of his hands in the eyesight of Yahweh. With the merciful, Yahweh will show himself merciful. With an upright man, he will show himself upright. With the pure, he will show himself pure. And with the forward, he will show himself forward, according to Psalms chapter 18, verses 16 through 26. For Yahweh is saving the afflicted people, but is bringing down high looks. For Yahweh is lighting the candle of YahwehBenYahweh. Yahweh, the God of YahwehBenYahweh, is enlightening his darkness. For by Yahweh, YahwehBenYahweh is running through troops, and by his God Yahweh, he is leaping over walls. As for Yahweh, his way is perfect. The word of Yahweh is being tried. He is a buckler to all of us that trust in him. For who is God save Yahweh? Or who is a rock save our God Yahweh? It is Yahweh that girds us with strength and makes our way perfect. Yahweh teaches the hands of YahwehBenYahweh to war, so that a bow of steel is broken by his arms. Yahweh is also giving YahwehBenYahweh the shield of his salvation and is holding up his right hand.
Remember that this is the morning of the third day, and I shall rise again. I am the resurrection. It, all of prophecy tells you that I shall rise again. It's all about that. Luke chapter 2, verse 34. No doubt about it. again. I love you forever. Bless you forever. I remind you once again, my associates are children of the light. That just brings laughter to my heart, to my soul, to realize that at last, I have those of you that love peace. And I only want to be in the presence of those of you that love peace. I love you forever. Shalom Aleichem.
Yahweh is God, and He is perfect in all His ways. It is Yahweh who girds us with strength and makes our way perfect. Hence, Yahweh is the rock of Yahweh Ben Yahweh, and He is enlightening His darkness. Yahweh has given unto Yahweh Ben Yahweh the shield of His salvation, and He is making Yahweh Ben Yahweh the head of the heathen. For all nations shall submit themselves unto Yahweh Ben Yahweh and obey Him. Therefore, we must rejoice and praise our King Yahweh Ben Yahweh, for He is worthy to be praised. Thank you for joining us in the universe of Yahweh. And now we'd like to invite all of you to pray with us as we turn to the east with outstretched hands and say a prayer to our Heavenly Father, Yahweh, the Lord's Prayer in Hebrew. Come, let us pray. Tefillah, Ave Nu Shabbat Shemayim, Yikar Deshimeyaka, Tavo Malkuteyaka, Yase Razonka, Kivashemayim Kain Ba'aretz, Et Lekum Kukenu, Tain La Nuhayom, Uslak La Nu, Al Kati Enu, Kimosha Sol King, Gamanaknu, La Koteam La Nu, Veal Tefienu, Lode Nisayom, Kin Kal Seinu, Min Hara, Kilaka, Hamamlaha, Veha Givara, Veha Tiferet, Leolame, Olamin Sila. We thank Thee, O Yahweh, O living and eternal King, who has so mercifully restored our souls within us. Selah. Praise Yahweh, and always remember that the Father, Yahweh, and His Son, Yahweh Ben Yahweh, love you, and your host loves you too. Shalom Aleichem.
To order the companion book to the series, The Messiah Revealed, call 1-800-967-PEACE. That's 1-800-967-7337. And when you call, ask about the special discount on A Global Call to the Remnant by Yahweh Ben Yahweh. Videos of this program are available. When ordering, please refer to the program number on the screen.
You can now access the divine mind of Yahweh Ben Yahweh on the internet at the address on the screen.